Hello students, good morning all of you ma, how are you all? Doing fine? Very good. Students, last class I have started gaseous state, that is the chapter 1, and in that we have done some introduction and also I have given you the derivation of ideal gas equation, and after that we have started deviation of real gases from ideal behavior, and under that also part 1 we have started that is effect of pressure on ideal behavior. And students, while giving you the syllabus, I have told that under this topic, that is under effect of pressure, there is a short answer question, that is compressibility factor, which can also be called as compression factor. Hope you have written the notes of last class. Okay, so we will continue from here now. Ready students? So open your books and put the side heading compressibility or compression factor. So what is this compressibility factor, students? So you all know the ideal gas equation for n moles of a gas is how much, students? What is that equation, do you remember? PV equals to nRT. This is called as ideal gas equation for n moles of a gas. Okay, now suppose nRT is on right side. Okay, so if I bring this nRT to left side, where will it go, students? PV by nRT comes to the denominator. Now what will be this PV by nRT equals to now? Is it 1 or 0, students? It is 1. Very good. So PV by nRT is equal to 1. Okay. Now, so this PV by nRT, this quantity is denoted as Z, which is nothing but compression factor or compressibility factor. Now this Z value is equal to 1. Okay, so I started with ideal gas equation for n moles of a gas. PV by nRT is equal to 1, that is Z equals to 1. Okay, so Z value is 1 for which gas, students? For ideal gases. Okay. So, but we know that in nature, none of the gases show ideal behavior. Okay. So, all the gases, they deviate from ideal behavior. That means Z will not be equal to 1 for real gases. So, what does it mean? This Z will be, or value of Z deviates from unity for real gases. So, how much this Z value deviates from unity, that will be the measure of how much real gases depart away from the ideal behavior, students. Okay. Now, to understand clearly the nature of deviation of real gases from ideal behavior, this is a convenient method. So, how will we know from compression factor the nature of deviation, or how the real gases are being deviated? Okay, so a graph is plotted between Z and the P values, students. So Z is what? PV by nRT. Okay, so on Y axis Z values are taken and on X axis P values are taken. Okay, so let us look at the graph plotted between these two values. So students, this is the graph plotted between Z and P values. Take a scale and pencil and draw the graph immediately without wasting your time. Draw the graph. On X axis, pressure. On Y axis, Z. If you want here, you can mention in the brackets PV by nRT. Okay, so mark a straight dotted line in the brackets, mention Z equals to 1. Below you can write, students, ideal behavior, and the gases shown here are hydrogen, helium, carbon dioxide, oxygen and nitrogen. Okay, so drawn, students. Fine. So what do we understand from this graph? We can infer three points from this graph. Okay, so write down the points under the graph, students. Point number one. So have you completed drawing the graph? Don't look here and there, students. Don't waste your time, please. Okay, now the first point. So students, as you all know, if the gas has ideal behavior, its z value will be equal to 1. And when a graph is plotted between z and p values, the curve obtained will be a straight line. Okay, but none of the gases has z value equals to 1. It will be either greater than 1 or less than 1. Okay, now what do we understand? The first point. Look here, students, we started from here. So as we move from here to right side, the pressure value increases. Okay, so at the low pressure values here, see students, this is the straight line. Okay, so at the low pressure values, we can see hydrogen curve, you take helium curve or nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide curves. If you observe, they are close to the ideal value. Okay, so here this value of N2 CO2 and oxygen or hydrogen helium at low pressure values, they are close to ideal value, not they are equal to ideal value, students. That means they tend to show ideal behavior at the low pressures. Okay, that will be our first point. Right up, at low pressures, all the curves approach ideal value. All the curves approach ideal values. Sorry, ideal values. Okay, full stop. Next, second point. So low pressures is done. Second point, at intermediate pressures. So as we move a little bit forward, what will you write, students? At intermediate pressures, comma, the gases show negative deviation. Look here, these values of nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, they are below the line. Okay, so that means what do we call in terms of deviation? It is called as negative deviation. So you can write, at intermediate pressures, the gases show negative deviation, but you should include something here. What is that but, students? Hydrogen and helium do not show negative deviation. So as we have discussed in the last class, from the beginning, their values are above the ideal line. Okay, so from the beginning, we can observe that their values are above the straight line. So you should include, but hydrogen and helium do not show negative deviation. That will be our second point, students. Written. Next, third point, at high pressures, all the gases show positive deviation. Okay, students, in the second point, the reason for hydrogen and helium not showing negative deviation, we will be discussing in the coming topics. Okay, I will definitely tell you why they are showing positive deviation from the beginning itself. Okay, so these are the three points, students, under compression factor or compressibility factor. Okay, students, this comes under effect of pressure on ideal behavior. Look, students, I told you deviation of real gases from ideal behavior. We have two parts, A and B. What is A? Effect of pressure. B is effect of temperature on ideal behavior. And under A, we have a short answer question, that is compression factor or compressibility factor. Okay, students. So moving on to part B, that is effect of temperature on ideal behavior. Kindly put the side heading, B, effect of temperature on ideal behavior. So students, B, effect of temperature on ideal behavior. So here also I have shown you a graph plotted between PV and P values at various temperatures. Okay, so draw this figure, students. You cannot find this in any textbook. For your understanding, I have plotted this graph so that we can understand easily at what temperatures the real gases are deviating much or to a greater extent. Please draw this graph, students. Show the temperatures 20, 40, 60, 80 and 100. 20, 40, 60 degrees, 80 degrees and 100 degrees centigrade. Okay, so what are you noticing here, students? At low temperatures, so we started at what temperature? 20 degrees centigrade, okay? At 20, how is the PVP curve? It is looking like a deep curve, okay? The depth of this PVP curve is very, very high, or it's more when compared to other curves. So we can say that the PVP curve at low temperatures is in the form of a deep curvature. Okay, now as we are increasing the temperature, what is happening to this deep curve, students? It is becoming horizontal, horizontal, horizontal. Finally, at the highest temperature, it has become almost a straight line. So what will you write from this graph? What will you write? We can write that at low temperatures, real gases are deviating from ideal behavior to a greater extent, whereas at high temperatures, they tend to show ideal behavior. Okay, students, from the graph, PVP curves at low temperatures are almost in the form of a deep curvature. As the temperature increases, this becomes horizontal, and finally, at highest temperature, it is almost a straight line. Okay, so these are the points you are supposed to write under this graph, students. So finally, conclusion you can write from this students, from this graph and the previous graphs. Okay, so we will write from the above graphs, it is understood that real gases deviate from ideal behavior at low temperatures and high pressures. Underline this point, students. At low temperatures and high pressures to a greater extent. Okay, so this you will write under effect of temperature on ideal behavior. Students, I have completed one essay question, that is deviation of real gases from ideal behavior, which is divided into two parts. Carefully listen. Don't ask me again and again what to write and where to write what. Okay? So the topic which I have completed, deviation of real gases from ideal behavior, under which we have A, effect of pressure on ideal behavior, under which we have seen compression or compressibility factor. Okay? Next, B, effect of temperature on ideal behavior. This is the complete answer for deviation of real gases from ideal behavior. Students, you will not be asked the question like, no one will ask you, explain the deviation of real gases from ideal behavior. Nobody will ask. So, how the question will be asked? Explain the effect of pressure on ideal behavior, or explain the effect of temperature on ideal behavior. Okay? So, or sometimes what happens, you know, students, it will be asked a short answer question, that is, write about the compression factor. So, you will write what Z is and how did you get that Z and what's the value of Z. Draw the graph and write down the 3 points. Okay? So, this is the topic that I have completed. What you will do is, you draw a line till here. Okay? So, moving on to the next topic. Okay, next topic. Put the side heading, van der Waals equation of state. Van der Waals equation of state. This is a very very important question, students. Put this side heading van der Waals equation of state. Okay. So we all know that PV equals to RT is called as ideal gas equation for 1 mole of a gas. Okay. So this is the equation of ideal gases, students. Okay. Now what van der Waals has done? He has modified this equation, this PV equals to RT as P plus A by V square into V minus V equals to RT. What did he do? He has added A by V square to P and he has subtracted B from V. Okay. Now this is applicable to the real gases. So how he has done this modification? By taking into consideration two factors of real gases. What are they? Volume occupied by the gaseous molecules, and the second factor is attractions among the gaseous molecules. What are the two factors, students? He has taken two factors into consideration. One, volume occupied by the gaseous molecules, and two, attractions among the gaseous molecules. Okay, now fine, this is the introduction of van der Waals equation of state. What will you write? The ideal gas equation for 1 mole of a gas is PV equals to RT, and this equation has been modified by van der Waals taking into consideration two factors, volume occupied by the gaseous molecules and attractions among the gaseous molecules, as P plus A by V square into V minus V equals to RT. So let us look into the derivation, how he has derived this expression P plus A by V square into V minus V equals to RT. Okay, students, put the side heading derivation. Put the side heading derivation. Students, this is a very very interesting question and also a very very important question. Okay, so I will try to make this question interesting, easy and informative. Okay, so how did he derive that expression? Number one, put the side heading correction in volume. So how he has subtracted the volume, that is some volume from capital V. Okay, now let us consider a container. Students, look here. This is a, just think or just assume it to be a container, and in this container a gas is being taken. Okay, and let us consider the volume of the container as capital V. Okay, now gas is taken in the container. So generally what do we understand from this, students? The molecules of the gas occupy the whole volume of the container. They will be running here and there as they lie in the container. Yes, you also think like that, right? For example, students, in a classroom, if there is no teacher, so how will you behave? Jump here and there from first bench to last bench. You will be calling, okay? So saying hi, greetings, wishes. So all these things will happen when there is no teacher in the classroom. Okay, so like this, likewise, the molecules of the gas, when they are in a container, generally we think that the molecules are enjoying in the whole space of the container. Okay, but what is the actual thing van der Waals has noticed? He noticed that this is not the case of the molecules. So some molecules, they were sleeping in the corner of the container. That means they are not at all interested in making noise. They are taking rest. That means they are not in motion. So this space is occupied by the molecules which are at rest or which are not in motion. Okay. So only few molecules are roaming here and there. Now for these molecules, this space is not available. Okay. Only this much space space is available. Okay, now you understood, students, capital V is not available. Less than V space is available for the molecules which are in motion. And therefore, what did he do? He has corrected or he has subtracted some space from capital V and he has corrected volume factor like this. So after correcting volume factor, the expression changes like this, students. P into V minus B equals to RT. Okay. So what will you write the points under this, students? Let us consider a container in which a gas is taken. We understand that the molecules are free to move in the complete volume of the container, which is considered to be capital V. Okay, but it was observed that few molecules are not in motion. They are at rest, occupying or blocking some space, and only less amount of space is available for the molecules which are in motion. Therefore, the correcting this volume factor, Van der Waal has changed the expression PV equals to RT as P into V minus B equals to RT. Understood, students? This is about the correction in volume. Okay. Next one, correction in pressure. How this A by V square is added to pressure factor, students? Ready to know? Right. Okay. So here again, a container is taken, but not the complete gas is taken into consideration. Only a single molecule A, which is present in the middle of the container, is now under observation. Okay, so a molecule present in the middle of the container, what will be its situation, students? Look here, from all the sides uniformly, it will be attracted or repelled by the molecules present on all sides uniformly. Understood? Consider a molecule. Okay, so those who can follow and write down immediately, you can write down, students. Consider a molecule which is present at the middle of the container. It will be attracted and repelled by all the molecules present on all sides uniformly. Okay, hence net force of attraction or repulsion, how much it will be, students? It will be zero. Okay, net force of attraction will be zero. That is about this first condition. Okay, next, coming to second container, the molecule which is close to the wall of the container is considered. Okay, now let us consider one molecule which is close to the wall of the container. What is it trying to do there? It wants to go and hit the wall or strike the wall of the container. Okay. Now, what is the situation of this molecule present close to the wall of the container? So, you can look here, students. The molecules which are present at its back, they will be trying to pull that molecule towards the middle of the container. That's what we call it as, it experiences an inward pull. Okay. So, shall I give you an example, students? For example, there is a group of friends. Okay. So, one friend wants to go out to canteen and get some puff or whatever. But the other friends, they do not want to allow this student to go out of the classroom. So, what will you try to do? You will try to pull that student to come inside the classroom. But even then, that student, as the student is feeling hungry, that student wants to go and get something from the canteen. Okay, so what the student will do? The student tries to go out of the classroom by using more energy or more strength of the student, him or her, whoever it is. Okay. So, like that, this student can escape from the friends and run away from the classroom. Okay. So, likewise, the same we can apply here also, students. This A, which is close to the wall of the container, it is pulled by the molecules which are present at its backside. Okay, but it wants to go and hit the wall of the container. The energy which it has is not at all sufficient. What it has to do? It should use, or it needs a extra force or energy to go and hit the wall of the container. Okay, so the pressure which it has is not sufficient. It needs some extra pressure or extra force, which is denoted by the letter small letter P, students, not capital letter. Generally capital letter we use it for pressure, right? So this is the extra pressure required by the molecule to go and hit the wall of the container. Okay, that extra pressure is denoted by small letter P. Okay, so what will you write, students? Let us consider a molecule which is close to the wall of the container. It will be attracted by the molecules present at its back, that is, it experiences an inward pull. Okay, in order to go and hit the wall of the container, overcoming these attractions, it needs some extra pressure or extra force, which is denoted by the letter small letter P. Okay, full stop. Now this extra pressure is proportional to, or it depends on, two factors, students. What are the two factors? Write down point number one, number of molecules present per unit volume, attracting the striking molecules, and point number two, the number of molecules present per unit volume, striking the wall of the container. Okay, students, so these two factors are responsible for the extra pressure needed by the striking molecule. Okay, now, so it is proportional to two factors. So I have dictated, I am not repeating, fine. Now, first up, these two factors, write on below, these two factors in turn depend on density of the gas. Okay, so two factors, number of molecules per unit volume, attracting the striking molecules, depend on density. Number of molecules present per unit volume, striking the wall of the container, proportional to D. Okay, so P proportional to D. Below write down, therefore, small letter P proportional to D square. D into D is D square. Okay, students, P proportional to D square. But D proportional to 1 by V. What is this, students? Density and volume, they are inversely proportional. Okay, but D proportional to 1 by V. Okay, therefore D square proportional to 1 by V square. D square proportional to 1 by V square. So finally, what do we write, students? Small letter P proportional to 1 by V square. Small letter P proportional to 1 by V square. Okay, so if we remove the proportionality, there comes a constant which is taken as A by V square. Okay, previously correction in volume V minus B, and students, there you can write down where small letter B is called as van der Waals constant or excluded volume. Okay, there, students, previous, that is correction in pressure. Fine. So here you can write down Finally, small letter p is equal to a by v square. Okay, so this should be added. Why? Because it is the extra energy or force required for that molecule which is present to close to the wall of the container. Okay, till here written, students? Therefore, after correction, in already correction volume we have learned. Therefore, after correction in pressure and volume, comma, PV equals to RT becomes, P plus A by V square into V minus B is equal to RT. Put it in a box, students. Below write down. This is called as van der Waals equation of state. Okay, so this is the answer for this question, students. Mark it as an important question. Van der Waals equation of state, you should write how he has modified, taking into consideration two factors and also the derivation. Draw a line till here, students. Okay, so what did we learn today? We have learned compression factor, effect of temperature, and another question, that is van der Waals equation of state. Okay, so students, this is all for today. Please write down all these points in your notebook. Don't ask me for notes again and again. Okay, so whenever I am teaching, I will be giving you the points like this. So you will write in your notebook. And please, immediately after the class, try to complete learning the questions. Okay, students. So see you next week. Meet you next week with a fresh new topic on a fresh new morning. Thank you. Bye-bye.